So, filtering patterns all have one thing in common. They don't change the actual records of our data. So by that I mean, if we have some long list of data with lots and lots of records, 1, 2, 3, and so on, a filtering pattern will go through the entire data set and just decide which data to keep and which to throw away. And so if this giant list is the input, this smaller list, this subset, of the original data would be the output. And there's a lot of ways filtering can happen. We can have a simple filter, which is basically just a function that returns keep or throw away for each of these records. And for the records that get kept, well, they wind up in the output. There's a bloom filter, which we're actually not going to talk much about, but it's worth knowing about because this is a much more efficient probabilistic filter that comes with some trade-offs, and you should check out the instructor notes if you want to read more. We also have things like sampling, which is just a way to make a smaller data set from a large data set by pulling out some sample, maybe the highest values of a particular field. If we want to pull out a representative sample, one that we think matches the characteristics of the original data, we can use random sampling. And finally, we can use this idea of filtering to find the, top 10 of something. And that's an exercise we're actually going to do later.